Welcome to another episode of our book writing studio, where we answer all your questions about book writing. And thank you for keeping your question coming. And the question for this week is, what makes a good topic? What should I write about? Should I write about marriage? Should I write about football? Should I write about becoming the best millionaire? Should I write about how to write a best-selling book? This is a place where you can become a best-selling author by understanding some basic technique on what makes a good book. There are three important components you need to understand if you want a good book topic. But before I go into that, I want us to understand the difference between a book title and a book topic. A book topic is a whole big category. Marriage is a topic. Writing a book is a topic. Choose a title of the book. And one of the big mistakes a lot of people make is they start writing their book with a title in their mind. That is a very big issue. Today we're not going to talk about how writing with a title in your mind is going to cause you to have a very bad book. I'm going to keep that for another day. Today I want to focus on a topic. What should I write about? If you're a first-time author and you want to think about writing, what can you write about that will get you to a statue of a best-selling author? There are three things you want to consider while you're writing. Number one is the problem. Number two is the reader. And number three is the solution. Why is the main focus on the problem? Why is it important that you focus on the problem? One thing you want to understand is that people pay for result and value. People do not just want to buy books because they want to buy books. No matter what type of book you're writing, is it a fiction or a non-fiction book, someone is buying it because they want to solve a problem. If probably you're writing a book about sport, if someone is not interested in sport, they're not going to buy it. So the problem is that they're interested about sport and they want to learn something. And if they want to learn about something, then who is that person that want to learn? Is it a kid of 10 years? Is it someone at the age of 20? Is it someone at the age of 50? So having a particular person that you want to reach your book in mind before writing that book is going to make you have a perfect book. And the third one is the solution. What solution are you offering them? So when you combine the problem, the reader, and the solution before choosing a book topic, you are going to write a perfect book. You're going to write a book that is outstanding. There are many other components that you consider while choosing a book topic. In our previous edition of the Book Writing Studio, we discussed about the book purpose, the purpose why you're doing it. I'm going to put a link on this video. You can click and watch the last session, which was the book purpose. The book purpose is the first step. The second step is understanding the topic. And when you understand the purpose, it aligns with your topic. You start writing effortlessly. That is why we say that when you understand how all of this play into place, when you understand the structure of a book, when you understand what you should think about first, what should come second, then it's very possible for you to get your book done in less than 40 hours. It's very possible for you to become a published author in less than 9 weeks, which is exactly what we help our best-selling authors do. We help them to be able to structure their ideas in a way that get them in front of the people that need your book. Before I go, I want to share with you a very brief conversation I had this week with someone that wanted to write a book, and we were discussing on what is the topic she wanted to talk about. And she said that, okay, I want to talk about single parents because my heart really go out for single parents. They need a lot of support and they need a lot of help. I said, yeah, that's a very good topic. But then, let's go back and look at the purpose. What's the purpose? Why do you want to write about single parents? It's like, I just love helping them. But when we kind of did another analysis, we noticed that it did not really match with her expectation, especially what she's doing as a business. And I gave her an advice and said, hey, look, Yeah, it's very good. Writing about single parent is good, except you just want to write as a hobby. But if you want to become a million-dollar author, if you want to make a living out of writing a book, then you should not just write because you have a passion about writing about music, you have passion about writing about sport. And that is one of the reasons why we have very good book out there in Amazon. The people have done a very great job, but the books are lying there. They're not changing their life. So, and we came to a conclusion that writing about single parent is a good start, but it's something that's not really going to help her. And we were able to come up with what is her interest. Her interest was more on communicating, was more on helping people to be able to get communicate what they need effectively and get their information or their message in front of the people they need. And that's what she's been doing. So we say, hey, look, why don't we talk about how communication could play a very big impact in the life of single parents in order to help them have a better successful life. Now, our focus was not just writing a book on about single parent, but she understood exactly what was the problem. And someone that is a single parent is going to come buy that book because they want to understand how they could use what they have, the different form of communication, to get out of that challenges which they're going through. So we see book topic is just beyond, it goes beyond just, I'm writing about this. It helps you to think about the problem you're solving, the who is reading, and the solution you're offering. And when you have, most importantly, the problem, the solution, and the reader in place, you realize that you are not just communicating for communicating's sake. You're helping people solve a problem. And that is one of the reasons they are going to pay you some very good money in order for you to help them. And that is one of the reasons they are going to consider you as an expert. So your book, writing a book, is a very powerful tool, but this only happens when you know exactly what you're communicating and to who you're communicating and what solution you're bringing. When you know this, you know your value as an author, and then you're on your way to write a best-selling book. Thank you for watching today. Do not forget to subscribe on my channel, leave a comment, and come back next week, Monday, for another session of our book writing studio. We'll be answering another key question. If you want me to talk about any topic, just drop your comment below and tell me, hey, Dr. Francis, I want you to talk about this topic. I have a question about book writing and other stuff. And you can also, the lot of other shows organized within the week. On Wednesday, on my Facebook page, we have our book writing workshop where we bring on board best-selling authors and communication specialists. And they communicate with you some real life problem and what it takes to write and what it takes to really put yourself out there. On Friday, we interview best-selling authors on their journey of becoming an author, and they also share with you what writing a book is doing in their life and how it has been able to help them reach the people they want to reach. You can watch all the previous interviews that have been going on my Facebook page. And also, for those who are in North America, I have a meetup group that is called Writing a Profitable Group. If you go on Meetup and type my name, you'll be able to find my group. Monday, 4 to 6 p.m., I have a lot of people that are coming together just for me to teach them what does it take to write a best-selling group. You can find me on other social media, on LinkedIn. You can find me there. I'm putting out a lot of content out there that is going to be beneficial for you. If you go to my website, drfrancisweb.com, you just spell drfrancisweb.com, you're going to find a lot of material. Just go to my blog. If you go to my blog, you're going to find material that will help you. Bro, do not forget to subscribe to my channel, subscribe, and you are going to get some really good videos. I'll be putting in all of these interviews on my channel so that you can learn from it, so that you can inspire, that they can inspire you to also become a million-dollar author. I'm also going to put a link for you to download our workbook. Our workbook gives you the step-by-step procedure on how you can write a best-selling book. I'm also going to put on a link about our webinar. Our webinar are coming up about 3 times a week. You can register to any of them. There I teach you how to write a profitable group. You ask questions and I answer. Thank you for watching today. I'm going to see you another day.